It's an older title from 1984. We may have some issues running it. We're going to be playing it in a DOS box. I tried finding copies to play, and I found some on some abandonware sites, but actually getting them to work is going to be another problem entirely. So we might get some wonky graphics and things, and do my best to deal with it. Give me a few minutes here to try to get it running first. So that's already true. Let's see what we can do. Ah, okay. First thing I have to change. Yes, it's... Yeah, I'd never heard of it before. You say somebody wrote it that's a pretty well-known Kami, is that right? Let's take this guy, and let's give it a try. We have success. Check my volume. Let's find that. Far from Earth, a distant sun rises over the desert planet Sish. Below, a hover skid flashes across the desert on its way home. Pilot Riss Velasquez looks forward to seeing his daughter again after several long months of garrison duty. Safari presents Chris Perkins, wow. So, like, lead dungeon master at Wizards of the Coast. Traffic Department 2192. I have no idea what kind of game this is, if it's like an adventure game or what. This is about the extent of the testing I've done this opening screen. A little bit of the game actually booting up, so I might have to change the overlay a little bit because the aspect ratio changes when the game actually plays. I'm also not sure if I'm able to make any save games in this. I did a bunch of research and I don't think there's a save game button. I think there's an ability to save, but you can't save whenever you want. There's only like preset points where you can do it. This one is actually in the master list, but it's just a question mark. That's correct. Twitch is pretty good about having a full game list. YouTube is the one that's pretty bad about that. Like, Off still isn't on YouTube. Just seconds away from the hangar, disaster strikes. That 94 CG. Burst of ion cannon fire tears the ship apart. Rick is killed instantly in the fiery explosion. Well, that's a bummer. His daughter watches from the hangar as her father dies. Warning, the original script for this game contains coarse language and sexually suggestive dialogue. Because the nature of this material may be considered unsuitable or offensive, an edited version is included. Please see helpme.doc. We're going to go with the original uncut version. Okay. Yeah, so there is like a save game or store game function, but I don't know where you would have to get to trigger it, because I couldn't find a command for starting it. So let's go ahead and start. Mission 1, Operation Recon. Craft Department Headquarters, July 18th, 2192. Routine assignments. Save Velda my face again and I'll rip yours off. Okay. Relay stations detected a convoy of Vulture supply trucks spreading out across the city. Guesses they're carrying arms and missile components, the lowlifes of Volthaven. Probably carrying more of those spice gangs. Vape the trucks before they leave the city. Consider it done. Yeah, right, sir. Okay, good looking out, poor Brewski. I'll do a test, and I might have to run it in a virtual machine. Commander Soterra can suck his... It's gonna be Kendrick. I don't care if it's Soterra's Trock grandmother, which I think is, like, future slang. You tell Soterra that I fly alone. Kendrick's just not in his hotshot. He doesn't value his life, let alone his wingman. Send him to me, and he won't return in one piece. Alright. Important hint. Read this. About to fly your first mission, complete your mission, simply follow the guidance line which circles the ship that you're flying. If the line is red, then the ship that it points to should be destroyed. If it's green, the targeted ship should be protected. If the line is blue, you should proceed to the location it points to. There are many other tools to help you complete your missions. By hitting escape during the game, you can reach your gameplay options. Select help from this menu to learn how to access these useful tools. Ball Buster. Okay, cool. I have a little ship. Some arrow keys. Let's see if there's a list of controls. So there's a white bar at the bottom, and that's because the aspect ratio of the game just changed. I can cover it up. In fact, I'm going to try that really quick with a line of black. But let me know if it's obscuring stuff in the future. Oh god, that doesn't work, does it? Because this has a different... this screen has a different aspect ratio as well. Alright, I'm just not going to worry about it. Just deal with there being some chrome white background on the DOS box I'm using at the bottom. Help. Alright. Arrow keys move, spacebar shoots. Tab switches between guns and missiles. Escape is menu. Zero and plus fire the afterburner. Pre-WASD is a standard at least. F5 is the map. F6 is communication when you're receiving one. Alt is infrared mode at night. Fantastic. Ship tracker. Brighter shades of red indicate the location of other ships relative to where you are. Number of missiles. Map. Current weapon. Onboard computer tells you what to do. Okay, cool. Assume I have infinite ammo. Maybe it looks like I have limited missile ammo. Okay, I see the little red radar now. Destroy the two trucks heading for the north entrance. Okay. Oh wow, turning's interesting in this game. It's like if you press back, if you press 180 degrees from the direction you're moving, you reverse. So if you want to actually turn all the way around, I know it's realistic. West and kill the escorts. Okay. Follow my little red objective indicator, which is kind of nice. 1994 to have like a clear objective indicator like that. Kind of think of that as a later game innovation, right? Doesn't seem to reflect average traffic department work. I mean, maybe in Austria. This is pretty standard in the US. That's really cool though. Like, I'm giving it mad props for being before its time for having that. I feel like a lot of games from this era would just have you wander aimlessly. Hope you luck out and bump into your target. A Vulture Patrol skid is entering from the east. Okay. And skids are these little cars that I'm driving right now. Hover cars. What about that non-hovering hover car? Is that making the music? Wow, he's doing some evasive maneuver shit. There we go. Mission complete. Return to base. Oh god, I don't know where base is. Is that the big blue light? Nice. First try. Yeah, music's good. Mission 120. Mission successful. 11 kills. You must concentrate on mission objectives. Okay, cool. 5 radians later. Interesting. The audio balance okay? It's unusual for me to play a game out of Chrome, so if you need me to crank it a little bit, I can. You should be able to hear me clearly, and also be able to hear the game clearly. Check it out yourself. You're a toad. That dispatcher guy has a 5-head like me. Commander Satare's office, traffic department headquarters, 25 radians over. Problem with wingmen? There's someone else's. Signing a pilot recruit training evaluation tomorrow. Tell with that idea. Gosh, she's so edgy. She's like the edgiest character ever. I'm the best pilot you've got. This game. It's like her dialogue needs to be read with a Trey Parker voice, right? This was before this started to get like relentlessly parodied by things like South Park. Like, this is the police chief complaining that somebody caused a whole bunch of damage. You took down that shopping mall, Velasquez! That shopping mall cost millions of dollars! Yeah, right. Hey, now we get to save. Okay, good to know. So as long as we finish a mission, we might not be on a mission save at the end. Also, I'm not sure if this will persist since I'm playing in a browser, but... Oh, put in a name. Okay. Yeah, Mayor! My ass! Exactly. Alright, next mission. Search and destroy. How many missions are in this? When you boot the game up, it gives you like 3 episodes to select from. Probably been like 3 separate floppy disks. Stairs got a new nursery. 30 per episode, okay. Before I beat the crap out of you. Jeez, calm down! Well, that's a dude, isn't it? Crack. No can do! Want your throat ripped out? Whoa! Destroy Vulture Convoy, destined for reactor. Destroy escort and convoy. Okay, roger. Got it. This terror can suck eggs. Burnt as toast. Other more different hint? Ship is outfitted with a communication decoder. If your strategic computer tells you that there is an incoming communication, hit F6 to view it. Okay, cool. It said it's very, like, 90s action movie, right? Just about every 90s action film at this time had the edgy... But I'm a cap! Like... Entering from the west. Alright, roger. F6. Please help me. I'm the sole survivor of a convoy I was ambushed by Vulture ships. My cargo is a batch of electronics from the forces that still oppose Vulture rule. Arriving in the east, please help me get to the truck depot safely. I have reason to believe the patrol ship entering the west is here to destroy me. Do if I can. Okay. So, like, side quests, basically, presumably. Green is the escort, right? Yes. Drive into a dead end. Well done. I know you're panicking. Overly edgy. Egg sucking. I wonder if my allied truck dies in one hit too, or if it's just the enemy ones. Okay. The enemy convoy is approaching. Hey, we did a side mission. Huzzah! Come, come. Yes, yes. Kind of cool. It's like you have to press left and then up in order to turn, you know? If you want to be able to shoot. I appreciate that the beginning of the game seems pretty forgiving. Like, your ship has really good shields and hull. Any reinforcements are arriving from the south. Okay. I guess I can just look at the icon and start moving there instead of waiting for the text to read out. There we go. Mission complete. Now a little blue thing tells me to go back home. Fantastic. This totally feels like the kind of game that would have mission fails like that, right? Cool. 5 kills, 16 to date. Concentrate on mission objectives. Trying. I don't know if this game actually has experience points or any reasons to do the side missions. Or if that just causes the mission to fail. It wasn't really a side mission. What's up, Vegeta's dad? Don't expect a medal. 20 missions per chapter? Okay, cool. Yeah, potential. I'm the best fucking pilot in the force. Yeah, see, this is exactly it. He's the police chief from a bad 90s action movie. Or a good 90s action movie. It's just the way they wrote shit then. Who in hell gave you the authority to reassign yourself to the search and destroy mission? You tamper with the mission assignments again, I'll have you drop it on the Vulture's doorsteps. Oh, just giving in for once. It was not a side mission. Is there such a thing as side missions in this? Probably not, right? Colonel Wolstenkroff's office. Vulture Command. The bad guys. You can't handle. Perhaps. Marta. She's thrown more than one of our operations. Keep saving. Oh shit. No. Let's not do that. I was just tapping the button to go up. I hit it one too many times. But it wasn't feeling responsive right away. Yeah. Traffic department. You're going around, like, destroying people. It's like a Ministry of Love thing, right? He seems nice. Yes, kitties, you're both very furry and so sleepy. Yeah. The meter maids, like, are the ones in charge of nukes or something like that, Yukipo. Most recent relay transmissions. Her skid is damaged, being pursued by two vultures. Get her back to the headquarters alive. And Marty's over here. They're just both out. They're so sleepy. I don't need one useless wingman to save another. Did you get it? I fly alone. Rescue. New ship entered from the west. I don't know if I actually want to be near my allied ships, because like the chance of me shooting them on accident is extremely high. Now, did I just fail the mission right then? I need to turn numlock off to use my afterburner. Maybe that's an ability I unlock later. Now I already have missiles. She didn't say suck eggs anymore, right? Yes, yes. They bleep the expletives. Incomplete. Failure of this mission will reflect in your record. I didn't realize I was allowed to fail missions and still progress. The silly bitch was taking a tour of the city and wouldn't just head home. Should resist temptations. Bastard soldiers of a new ship. I think that the croc shit. Like the croc shit pilot wouldn't engage me. Yeah, there you go, right? You could vote. They missed an opportunity there. Yeah, I thought I did, but, like, I was expecting the game to end immediately, and I was surprised when that didn't happen. So, can I keep playing from there? Is it recommended that I keep playing, or should I load my save? Yeah, I think maybe that's the difference between the episodes where I'm too sure. It's like you have 20 missions on the same map that have different rules each time. So like, you know, escort this person that doesn't really move very much, escort this person that does move but doesn't have guns, escort this person that moves but doesn't have guns, and so on. Keep going. Is failing a like consequence of having too many mission failures? Is it a bad idea for me to fail a bunch now and then not have room to fail on a harder mission later on? Because I could probably succeed at that one if I really pushed at it. Yeah, no, I like that too, Polar Brewski. But it has to be a game that, like, doesn't make it trivial to reload and try again, and doesn't make it always correct to reload and try again, you know what I mean? Like, you can let you keep going, but if, like, the game, if you get less game, if you don't pass every mission, then it's still a false choice. You still have to do every mission. Game over if you critical fail. But there's no... So I could fail every single mission in the game and still, like, get to the end. It won't stop me from progressing. If I fail, but not critical fail, I should say. Big sneeze, Ben. New ship on the streets. Vulture Mark II. Fast, maneuverable, and armed with forward-firing ion cannons. Fantastic. How many of the suckers do these vultures have? Dialogue's different when you fail. That's really cool. I like that. Oh, BT dubs, there are lizard people. Rumor has it that the vultures are developing new shields. Stop this in my ear, scale face. He's like sitting across the room from you. In Trails in the Sky, the game's series bosses are a required story fight you don't have to win. I like that, Spikey. That's cool. Yeah, that's pretty brilliant. If you can put it late enough in the game, I think that's pretty genius. Guys, I'm on the Mark IIs. Sure. I'm probably gonna have to save Scum in XCOM. XCOM's so brutal that the sequel assumes you lost the first game, right, Oversky? Infrared display. Go to the streets where vultures scum and do the usual thing. Clith? Wonder if he's the scale guy. Then you're not Solarian. Oh, the lizard people, probably. Watch out for civilian cars. Might even want to protect them for once. It's a magic word. Death. Alt for infrared. Cool. Ah, but in alt infrared, I can't see what color my objective actually is, right? That's interesting. I'm not sure if I can know if it's a civilian ship or not. Come now. There we go. Trails in the Sky has some similarities with Skies of Arcadia. I remember it coming up during Skies of Arcadia as a somewhat similar game. Probably want to use missiles on the Mark II if we can, right? I'm not confident in my ability to aim at all. Like so. There we go. Vulture is destroying civilians in the southeast. Presumably where I am right now, question mark? This is where the objective meter is sending me. Return to base. I think I just killed a civilian. Oops. Womp womp. You get a decent pilot. Her arm is improving. Mission successful. Hooray! Mission over with. Oh, dispatcher. He's so inappropriate. Meanwhile... Yeah, right. Who cares about civilians? They're in the way of you ripping the heads off those vulture freaks. Vulture Captain Moloch. What a nice name. Demeter has made his move. Demeter's a he? Spawn our happy coop? How do we take the Splinter faction to Satyr's do-gooders for an escort? Interesting. I think Serp has his finger on the pulse of 90s action dialogue. I don't think you could make one of these sorts of movies with a straight face anymore. In modern day, like, irony-obsessed filmmaking culture. Kung Fury does a lot of the parody of that sort of thing, too. Oh yeah? How does it work, Spiky? Or she sleeps uneasily. She relives her father's death, awakes in cold sweat. At the Operation Coordinator's office, she finds the cause of her pain. Bullock? Captain alive? extremely dangerous pilot, terminate with extreme prejudice. Bastard who murdered my father. Good thing he has an important name then. Escort mission. Didn't startle me, I could smell you 6 kilometers away. Should tear that forked tongue right out of your damn mouth. At least wait until after the mission. Don't make me nauseous. God, she's such a bitch. She's really nasty for no reason. Is there a nice, friendly, lizard man? She's all, like, alien racist, too. Your wet dream, sugar tits. Oh, boy. This is Aaron Demeter, so he's a douchebag from The Bad Guys. Oh, okay. I guess Lost Odyssey does that too, right? That was nice. I like them fading to black and coming back and showing the Street Fighter portrait. Less than usual. Did I put too much cream in your mug? Oops. That's gonna be funny. Oh, that's really cool, Spiky. Really, Farfrisky? It's pretty great. They thank Kami for adding it. I had never heard of it before. So it's written by Chris Perkins, the lead badass DM guy at Wizards of the Coast. I am playing this for free on playdosgamesonline.com. It's actually the easiest way for me to possibly play it. There's also like 6 or 7 abandonware sites you can get it on, but you'll probably have to run it in a virtual machine. Blow them to pieces. Go bake in the sun, lizard breath. Guarantee eggs assistance. I love, like, alphabet soup acronyms all over the place. Yeah, there's a lot of old DOS games that are basically abandonware, so no one's bothering with trying to manage the rights anyway. Just trying to get them to run natively on your machine, you're gonna have a bad time, right? Bright red means I'm close to an enemy. Looks like I can tank them, it looks like. F6, what do we got? Southern exit's too heavily guarded by vulture ships for me to exit. I'm proceeding the eastern gate instead. I always knew you were a chicken, Demeter. Get on my VidCon, you son of a croc. The, like, games that have fantasy swear words. Stands up a lot more, though, when it's like they just take something about the universe and use, like, a real-world slur, but, like, fit the fantasy element into it. So, like, if you're any universe that's polytheistic, people are like, "Gods damn it." I'm like, man, no, are they really gonna say "gods damn it"? Okay. I get it. Yeah, frack's a good one. That's one. Come, young. Come, come. Yes, 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 yes. Yes, 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 yes. Oh my god. Can you die already, please? I hate you. Oh, if I had the regular guns, I would have been set there, I think. Wait, maybe we got it. Hooray! Success, presumably. Success, perhaps. If you say in real life. There we go. Cool. Magic doesn't suck and CP isn't shared. Ah, okay. That's cool. Decent pilot. Her aim is improving. Hooray! Didn't actually murder anybody that time. That's really good. It's exciting. Scum suckers out of the city. At least I'll rest easy tonight. But thanks, dispatcher. Ha ha ha! Oh, he's so boring, it makes her sleepy. He was talking about sexual relations, though. What do you see when you gaze beyond this window? Playground? Traffic cop has become a nuisance. About to introduce new technologies that will sweep away the traffic department and others who stand in our way. Okay. Erase the lieutenant. Off we go. It might be, I mean, Chris Perkins is a pretty goofy dude, right? No jabbing quips, no hustle remarks. Blow it out your ass, rock's breath. Too many syllables for you to handle? Do you want a wingman? Do you want to die? God. Hey, a new important hint. Flying a stiletto on this mission, the fastest ship. With four cannons, the ship also has afterburners for short bursts of incredibly high speed. Get around the city quickly, but they're highly effective in combat. Use insert with a large plus on your numeric keypad, or the second button on your joystick. I didn't know I could play this with a joystick. What if I just turn it on, it works natively. If it doesn't crash the game. That was a bad decision. It does recognize that it's here. Whoops! That's a mission fail right there, isn't it? There we go. What's up? There you are. Did blow away your father. One of my more challenging kills. That's both you and your ugly face into a billion ions. It's like, well, I think that if you blast him into a billion ions, you've automatically blown his ugly face into a billion ions. But okay, we can talk like that. Nice dream. I don't know if the speed boost actually is helpful in combat. I kind of have a hard enough time aiming this thing anyway. Destroy the three other vultures. Yeah, memorizing this grid would definitely be helpful. Where are you at? The primary source of failure in this game is definitely going to be blowing up friendlies. And it's probably going to be friendly fire against friendlies, even more so than like letting them die to enemies. Nice. Back to the base. Yes, yes. What is the meaning of being a traffic agent? Hey, mission successful. Not yet, Ben. Big yawn. Right? She got toasted. Just another surf in the desert. Today's his birthday. I couldn't care less. She's such a badass, she doesn't care about people's birthdays. He can eat my ions. Oh, that dispatcher. What a goof. What's going on in Hyde all of a sudden? Your new shields have yielded less than perfect results. Seems Moloch may underestimate the skill of the opposition. Neither of you for Harkin Moloch's miscalculation. He's still alive, right? We wouldn't get to kill him in, like, the seventh mission. He's the one who killed our dad. Well, it turns out he wasn't actually the one who killed our dad, and somebody else was. Each egg mine is equipped with a recognition sensor, allowing our vehicles to pass over it safely. Oh, well, that sucks. Building the design space of the map. No shielding on their underbellies, so the streets soon become too treacherous for the vehicles. No more driving fast. Got it. Yeah, I know, right? It's like printing out each character separately. Spies working for the Splinter Faction provided technical schematics for the new Vulture Egg Mine. Apparently they're vaping those damn trucks. Chill out. Gordon was an idiot. The only thing he could drive was someone crazy. What are our faces? I want you to stop on one. Oh my god. Marta. The only thing Lazar can handle is his penis. Is there anyone in the world you like? Anyone who hates your guts. Now, don't challenge her on that. Because someone else she is, suppose the dispatcher hates his guts. Now you have a conundrum. And how do you get out of that one, Marta? Don't insult me. Destroy all the mines. Also, try not to drive over them accidentally. You're probably right. I'm actually kind of impressed with the amount of, whoops. Hey, Sailor Dan. This game's called Traffic Department 2192. Pretty pathetic. Yeah, let's retry the mission and not drive over the mine this time. It's a DOS game from 1984. Sublock. Yeah, right. There we go. It's pretty cool though, Kami. Actually impressed at like how much progress I've been able to make in it. Usually these DOS games were really brutal, but this one has a little objective marker and actually has a pretty decent difficulty curve in the early game and doesn't cause the game to end if you fail a minor objective. Before its time in that respect. Oh shit. Okay. Don't drive fast around corners. Way to waste a ship. You can do better. Yes, yes, I'm sorry. I guess this is probably the first mission where you're actually likely to die. There's things that can one-shot you. The other ship's guns don't really penetrate your shields. Let's go slow. Presumably those lay extra mines, question mark? Oh god. So much for the ship guns not being a big deal. Yeah, it's not that it's not hard, it's just that it's reasonable at the beginning, right? It doesn't require you to read a 200-page manual. Like some of the other older games we've played have been much trickier in that respect. Especially like old PC games that aren't adventure games. DOS titles. Even say like Commander Keen's pretty brutal. It's not that bad, but. Oh shit. Oh, it's so hard to slow down. I think as soon as I think I'm close to a mine, I just gotta slow down. Sure, avenge your father's death by getting your butt kicked. God, the game over screen is mean. Yeah, that'd be nice, Spiky. Let's see if we can get one more dialogue sequence before we wrap up. It means not dying again. Slowly. Careful. Just keep shooting and hope we don't accidentally shoot a civilian. I'm guessing the team that made this is probably defunct, right? Careful. Now, I own all of the other times I died. I don't know if that was that was my fault. Was there a mine on the screen that I flew over? I just get shot a whole bunch or blow up a mine when I was too close to it. Game over, yeah! You're wasting a life. No reason to even continue. We gotta get more of that 90s action movie writing. That's why I became a cop. Take Nabbit Murder! Can't go destroying million-dollar mini malls. That's one of my favorite lines in Demolition Man, which is one of the best movies ever. You should totally see it. Sly Stallone. Oh, there's an edge to the map, and you could bounce off the edge of the map, and the bounce is enough to push you over the mines. Oh, this level is so much harder than everything else they've been up to this point. Oh, boy. Anyway, there's this scene where they're giving Sylvester Stallone shit for blowing up a mini mall that was like, you know, $10 million installation for a girl whose ransom was only $50,000, and the little girl he's carrying is like, fuck you, lady! Oh god. No. Oh, if the truck places a mine, it can kill you as you're driving. Someone tried to remake this 6 years ago but didn't finish. Okay. Yeah, that's cool. I'd be interested to see what they tried to do with it. It seems like this game wouldn't be too difficult to remake in the context of other, like, games from this era. I definitely want to kill that truck. Oh, it's zoomed out? That's nice. Yeah, my lack of field of view, like, this mission normally wouldn't be terribly hard if I could see further ahead than, like, two ship lengths. But if I'm moving with any sort of speed and there's a mine kind of off to the side from me, it's GG. Don't die exactly the same way here. There we go. If it's slow and turn corners suddenly. I'm trying to get it so that the line is like straight so I can shoot it while I'm driving toward it, right? Oh my god. Ah, I thought I had it. That one must have been placed recently. Their alpha's out? Interesting. I wonder how many, did they just like do a certain number of missions and then stop? I don't think we're gonna get some more dialogue before this sub-block is over. Before we switch to East Origin. Kill that Mark II. Some bad news bears, otherwise. He left me alone, though. It appears the mines and the truck are always in the same place, so you could solve this level the old-fashioned way you've played games like this, which is just memorize the level layout, right? Okay, so they have an explosion radius that's about a square outside of them, so even if you blow them up with a gun, they can still kill you. I think you generally want to be destroying them from the left or right, so that you have a chance to not die. Got it. Vultures go. I can't go any faster than this. I'm already very much in death range right now at the speed I'm traveling. All the mines have been destroyed, thank god. Jeez. Don't get killed by one of the Mark II vultures, they're really dangerous. There we go. First try. Yeah, exactly. Much less time to react to things vertically, horizontally. Definite improvement, more advanced fighting skills needed. I'm guessing the computer files note is a function of how many mission successes I've had. Versus failures. Made an omelet out of those egg layers. I hate omelets. He was complimenting you! God! Oh, my famous croc egg omelet. Let me make you once a time. You can't even make friends. Flatterer. Okay, you gotta do like a Randy from Futurama voice for the dispatcher now. By the way, Commander Sotero wants a personal report by 0600 hours. Sotero wants a private urinal. Doesn't mean he's gonna get one. Guy. You hate things? I hate things too! Yeah, she's probably the edgiest protagonist I've ever seen in a game. Pretty great. She's struggling. Malik maybe actually is dead. The surprise is about to hatch. Get it? Because they're like bird people. His first name is Bran. Like, I feel like the basic reward structure of this game, and we talk about this in a lot of games, right? Like, the basic reward structure of Phoenix Wright is seeing people break down. This game, it's every line of dialogue from the protagonist. When our surprise has thawed. Alright, so depending on how tough the next mission is, this might be our last save for today. Let's see. Big yawn, Ben. Oh, so comfy. One fell swoop. Sick of her being such a jerk. That's cool. Her face is all screwed up. Aren't we on the same side? Get off the drugs, Kendrick. That's what the spice-sorting bureaucrats want you to think. They're all slimes with gelatin guts. Of course, you gotta have spice in the future, right? Questionable enough already. Most of the characters in this game have a five head. That's pretty cool. Don't bother trying, just vape them all. Just ignore her at this point. That's your problem. Taking him out, you mean? I feel like she'd be a fun character to play in a tabletop setting, right? As long as she had, like, there had to be a plot element that forced her to cooperate. Because she'd be the kind of character that would just grind the story to a halt for being such a huge jerk, so you'd have to have, like, a command spell or something on her to make her do missions. Don't think for one radian that I actually like you. Koth seems like a perfectly nice lizard person. Don't be such a jerk. Well, that's pretty cool. I wasn't expecting that to happen. I thought it was just like she's like generic Edge. Not like actual kill the force Edge. Now you see me, now you don't. Something, something, Tokyo. Fast and Furious. Oh, shit. Assume those are bad trucks. I legit thought that's how that song went for the longest time, because that's how Andrea sings it. And then we saw that she showed me the movie, finally. Whenever she takes a corner tight, she sings that. And I was like, those aren't the song lyrics at all. Now you see me, now you don't. Something, something, Tokyo. Fast and the Furious. Come on. It's actually kind of ballsy, though, that they have all that bad shit happen to the protagonist, and that's just a dark ending. I thought I was dead. Commander Moloch. Clone? I look forward to killing you, finally. Moloch isn't actually dead? Now, due to the power of vulture cloning, there are two of me! There is two of them! We will destroy you, prepare for your death! Kill you two more times when I have to. See if they cloned you properly without a spine, what? Oh man. Yeah, BT Dubs cloning it in this setting. There we go. Turn to base. And we'll probably call it after we get to the next save point and boot up East Origin here. Commander White or Rain Beer Court. Probably couldn't light a candle with her. The personality of a sand shark. Hey, she's being less of a jerk to the dispatcher. I don't agree with your methods, but goddammit, you get the job done. So clone Moloch before he died. Examples break down after two or three replications. Oh, okay, good. I'm glad they're giving us a universe reason why they can't just make infinite clones of Moloch. No trace of Moloton particles? Moloton bombs. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Y'all stupid. Y'all so stupid. There's a great old YTMND that mashes up Weird Al's UHF with the movie 7. I think it's like what's in the box at YTMND.com. I wouldn't put that URL in for sure. A red snapper! Very tasty. Alright, see you, Kami. Alright, we'll be back in a few minutes, guys, with East Origin. Thank you for sharing that game, Kami. That was pretty cool. It's another game I don't think I would have played if it wasn't for Twitch. Back soon.